Sorry, don't hit. Shit. You pull up, she gon' pull up too. You can buy that, she can buy that too. She got her own.
Shawty just a bad bitch with her own shit. She don't need you.
The baddest bitty in the city is up. I literally just woke up. It's 8:01. I have to go grocery shopping for sure because I literally have nothing in my fridge. And yeah, it's about time to put some food in here. There's my list. Every now and then I'll add something different. Sometimes I don't even get all this stuff on here, but I'm gonna go to the farmer's market. What sign am I? If we done, we done. Please don't text me because I will text you back. This is sad, just something sad. Anyway, I'm about to hop up, get today started, take her for a walk, and then probably the first stop is gonna be is the grocery store. What's the vlog without going to Target?
I don't want to wear this bag. Of course, I won't be wearing my house shoes outside. I don't know if I want to wear this bag. This bag.
All right, so which one? Should I do this one or this one? This one or this one? Jersey, what you think? I feel like I'm going to do this one because I am going grocery shopping. I'm doing running around. This is more smaller. So,
let's go. So, the first stop I'm at. Edges is late. First time I'm at is Target because my skin has been doing backflips like all the time. And my esthetician was like, you know, maybe it's the water like in your town. And I was like, I never thought about that because like where I'm from, the water's good, the water's clean, the water's pure. So bought a water purifier to put in the bathroom and it didn't even freaking fit. So it's this thing right here. So it didn't fit on top. It didn't fit on my bathroom sink because of the type of sink that it is. It's not like a basic sink like in this picture right here. So I'm just going to return this. I really wish I could use it, but I'll probably have to end up getting a filter that goes underneath the sink versus on top of the sink because I know that there's one that you can filter the water from below the sink. So I'm getting ready to return this or exchange it. What else did I buy today? Oh, exchange it and probably just get like some toothpaste and mouthwash because I'm running out of toothpaste. I have another one because I always buy two of everything, but I'm just gonna like get another toothpaste since I'm about to run out of that, so I don't have to worry about that when I gotta buy it.
They don't have a free one. That freaking sucks. I hate when I come in and don't have a free one. My mom has this one. It wasn't bad, but it has fluoride in it, and I do not like toothpaste with fluoride in it. What about this one? It's just for nighttime. And, no, I'm gonna continue to stay freaking organized. So I'm like, let me look at these planners. They are kind of giving, but they're kind of not giving. Oh, this one is cute. But I be trying to match everything. Oh, this is just a notebook. I be trying to match everything that I buy to my home. And my home is very, like, black, gray. So when I buy stuff, I always try to match my house to that. Oh, this is cool. 3,000 questions about me. Can you blow a bubble with bubble gum? Have you ever dedicated a song to anyone? If so, what song? Then exercise matter. Have you ever played the bongos? What do you appreciate? This is cool as fuck. Like, why I feel like I need to get this?
So I'm at Starbucks. And I'm like, sheesh. I asked Instagram because I've never, like, I had Starbucks before, but I think I had, like, a matcha, green tea matcha or something like that. And it wasn't bad. Oh, this line moving kind of fast. Okay, good. It wasn't bad, but I'm like, I could go inside, too, but I really don't want to go inside. I'm probably getting out the car. I'm one of those people. If I got to go somewhere, the less getting out, the better. But, hold on, y'all. Let me put y'all down. Keep talking shit saying I'm gonna get a damn car mount. I'm gonna get one. I'm gonna order it on Amazon today. But right now, I'm about to pop up my camera with some sanitary napkins.
A little janky, y'all. Forgive me ahead of time, please. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I'm at Starbucks now. So I asked Instagram. I was like, hey, I'm at Starbucks. I'm going to Starbucks. What should I get? So I'm not a coffee drinker at all. Like, rarely. I used to drink like frappes a long time ago. Like caramel frappes, my mom, like we used to get them from McDonald's. I don't know if that counts, but they used to be hitting. But I'm like, I think I should go inside. Damn, I should
Damn, because people going inside and coming out relatively quickly. But the line inside look long, too, for real, for real. Like, I'm not going to hold you. But I be seeing on TikTok that they be moving kind of fast anyway, so, yeah. But anyway, so I'm not a coffee drinker because I am someone who's, like, is that Candytopia? Like, that place that people be going to that's really fun? I'm sorry. Anyway, yeah, I'm not a coffee drinker, so I was like, So we got some recommendations. I got a venti drink, which is venti drink that is a lemonade, 7 pumps classic syrup, 3 pumps raspberry syrup, and the strawberry bees. I don't know. That's something that might have me a little bit on edge. That's a lot of sugar. I'm like, I don't know. But then somebody also said a peach green tea lemonade. I'm like, okay, that sounds real slight, real light. Like, that don't sound bad. So I might try that. But my line sister, she wrote pumpkin spice frappe tall. That sounds so goddamn good. Like, it sounds similar to a caramel frappe. And the caramel frappe wasn't like coffee to me. Like, I didn't taste the coffee in it. So I'm like, maybe I'll get that. Like, you know, just to be festive-y or whatever. And if I don't like it, then I just don't like it. But I feel like it's gonna be good. But I'm wondering, can I get that pumpkin spice frappe with, like, almond milk, or I'm pretty sure I can't, almond milk or oat milk or something like that, because whole milk is just not my thing. So the line is moving relatively quickly. All right, y'all, we about to order. I'm nervous. Oh, wrong window. Hi, this is actually my first time. I'm sorry, give me 1 second. Can I have the pumpkin spice frappe tall? What milk do you use in that?
Whole milk.
Whole milk, okay. What are other options, like plant-based milks you have?
You have non-fat, oat milk, coconut milk, almond milk.
Okay, I'll do it with oat milk, please.
Okay.
That'll be all, thank you.
Wait, did you say water with whipped cream?
Oh, no whipped cream. Thank you. Oh yeah, because I definitely forgot whipped cream is definitely, like, damn, see, that's the thing, like, people, businesses should have, like, freaking vegan or plant-based whipped cream. Okay, sorry, don't hate. Shit. I did say no whipped cream, but I actually do want whipped cream.
You do want whipped cream?
Yes. Is that possible? If it's not possible, then don't worry about it. Thank you. So I asked people, I'm like, what do I get when I go there? Because I don't want to be, like, wrong, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, is it something? Well, you got one of our seasonal items, so that's a good
one. Okay, so that's good.
Start with that. Do you need a receipt?
Yes, please.
Well, here you go.
Oh, all right. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Have a good day. What's your name? So much. Have a good day.
You're welcome.
Okay, Starbucks. I had to, you know, take my pads out the joint because, oh, I can keep my camera right there because I was using the prop of my phone. You're probably like, this bitch got it. Oh, see, this is too much. Let me just pull over so I can taste the joint. Good God Almighty. I got a tall. That's weird because if this is a, did I say tall? This is a tall. Like, this don't look like no goddamn tall to me. Well, I mean, clearly it's their tall, but, like, this is a tall. It smells good. Let me get my photo. Niggas like, let me get my photo. It's me needing my nails done. Okay, let's try it. I don't really taste the pumpkin. I thought I was gonna be like, that's what I'm looking for. You know how certain things are, like, super duper potent in flavor and you taste it? It doesn't really taste like pumpkin, which is actually pretty good. Oh, shit. This is good as hell. Mm-hmm. Okay, time to go. guys. So I literally just got done. Say hey, sis. I'm recording. You in the background, girl. I just got done going grocery shopping. I'm about to go to... Oh, I got to go to Sephora. I totally forgot. I need to get some sunscreen. This is what happened when your mom be all over the place. I got to go to Sephora to get a sunscreen. Then I'm going to go to market. To everywhere that I think I needed to go today, which is really, really good. I feel like today was a productive day. Today not even over yet. I have class, so I'm about to rush home right now.
The name of love. Mm. Love doesn't hurt. It does not hurt.
Mm.
You know what hurts? Betrayal, humiliation, yes. Lies hurt. Now, can someone that love you betray you? That hurts. Yeah, but it's not love. It's the act of
rejection. Right.
Did y'all get that?
Yes, we got it.
When you're doing something out of love, you don't have to preface it. It's just like saying, I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but guess what's going to follow after that?
Yeah.
Right.
I just cut
you off, but.
That is a great example. That's how I see tough love. When someone says that they're not all the time, let me say this. Because you know what I do realize in the substance field, tough love is something that they use. It is. And I do believe that there are people who are able to do it effectively. But again, it's just like, have you ever, and we gotta move forward because y'all have work to do. Have you ever interviewed or worked with a client and they say, I got whippings, but everybody gets whippings. I mean, it was the natural whipping with an extension cord. Mm-hmm. See, but that's what I'm saying. Which creates this idea that that wasn't abuse. Which can, if you create an idea that, now, listen, anybody out, because it ain't even spiked with an extension cord, and I'm just using that as an example. The point that I'm making is, it creates a space for your tolerance of something to be much higher. So in your mind, if being spiked or with an extension cord, then something else less than an extension cord would be way more acceptable. Well, it wasn't an extension cord, but it was a broom. Or it wasn't a broom, it was a switch. Or it wasn't a switch, it was a... So that's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
When we allow, and that's what we're doing that assignment, when you allow certain words to describe what you're doing, it almost waters down the actual action. Does that make sense?
Yes.
That's it. That's what I was trying to get to with that tough love. That's why I don't like when people say tough love. Or if I hear it, I'm like, okay, tell me a little bit about what that tough love
is. What is that? What is tough love?
Yeah.
What does it mean to you? What is love? I'm going to say this, but I'll move forward. When I'm working with couples and they're having a difficult time, and you can think about this even in your own relationship, and people say, we're in love, but what is love? And I have my couples to define what love is. And I'm not talking about from whatever your spiritual belief is, like the Bible or the Quran or the... No, what is your ideal love? Is it protection? Is it support? Is it whatever it is? And you write them down. And then you begin to describe whatever relationship you're in, being with a friend. If your friendships or your relationships aren't matching your idea, then it's probably not love.
Mm-hmm.
But then you've convinced yourself that it's love, where it's love that hurts, or love that, and it's just not. And so, let's go with our first day.
Wait a minute. Well, do we have to? That was getting good.
Can I make a comment?
Of course.
I really like that you're like going on and on about tough love, because I actually feel like what you're trying to get at is you're putting the power back into the person that's receiving the behavior instead of the person that's doing the behavior. And I like it.
That was awesome. Once you can identify you as a clinician, you as a therapist. Guys, we were on the path of doing two things. We have two people that are presenting today. we have two people that were presenting today. Let me share something with you. It should be two tapes.
I think it was good. So when your client talks a lot, it's hard for you to interject without feeling like, oh my gosh, I don't want to cut them off. But also because they talk a lot and they say so much, you don't know what to say. I noticed that a little bit in here. Like I said, I do think you did good, but it was kind of like, I feel like because so much information was given to you, it was hard to like conceptualize what to say back. You know what I mean? Yeah. The suggestion, I know you have her reading boundaries, but I would think of like grounding techniques, because I feel like she has a lot going on. She needs to be grounded. Like, I feel like, you know.
Yeah. I got my peaches out in Georgia. Ooh, yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass bitch. I get my life right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it. And I see you, the way I breathe you in. It's the texture of your skin. I wanna wrap my arms around you, baby, never let you go. And I see you, there's nothing like your touch. It's the way you lift me up, yeah. And I'll be right here with you till the end. I got my teachers out in Georgia, yeah, shit. I get my weed from California, that's that shit. I took my trip up to the north, yeah, badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah, yeah, that's it. And I got my teachers.
Store. I done went to the gym. I went to class. Like, I have been all over, sis, okay? Like, I just got in the house. But I'm like, let me take a quick second before I, like, take a shower, eat, and really just sit down, because I'm ready to, like, sit down and eat and go to bed. Show y'all what I got at the store. I got some Brussels sprouts frozen. I always, for the most part, I always get frozen vegetables. They're easy for store, to like store, and they last longer. I got tons of broccoli, so I got three things of broccoli. I went to Aldi and Trader Joe's. This is everything I got from Aldi. I got some hash browns. I love these to have in the morning with just egg, vegan sausage, whatever. I love hash browns. I got some OJ, so I got two of these. I was like, I should get some champagne so I can make my own mimosas. I also got some cranberry juice, because I've been rocking with the cranberry juice lately, so I got two of those. From Aldi, I got two pineapples as well. These. I just poked myself. I probably shouldn't have did that. I'm tired today, y'all. I got some peaches. Now, I was waiting to record this so I can pop these peaches open, because I just got done working out. I'm hungry, but I also meal prepped already. So I got some peaches. So all that came from Aldi. Oh no, I have more stuff from them. I also got some limes, because I do my lime shot. We already know that. Some avocados, because we're going to be doing avocado toast this week. Life hack, avocado hack. If your avocados are not ready, wrap them up in a brown paper bag. They should be ready in about 2 days, maybe 2.5. It really depends, but it's a hack. It works. Brown sugar. I want some yellow brown sugar. I got two of these, two brown sugars. I use them to make a brown sugar scrub, but also every now and then I'll put it inside my oatmeal, depending on how I'm feeling. But most of the time, I'm going to use it for a brown sugar body scrub. And y'all should get your braids be everywhere. I got some more onion powder. Needed another one of these. Some coconut oil. I typically use the one that's already like melted, but I'm like, let me just get the cold press one because I'm already here. But I use coconut oil as a not an oil rinse, but like oil pull, that's what it's called. So I'll take either the liquid form and like swish it around, or I'll take this cold press form and like put on the spoon, put it in my mouth and swish it around. But 9 times out of 10, I will most likely sit this outside so that it can melt and I could just use it in the same way. But that's why I got this coconut oil. Jersey is eating, so if you hear crackling in the background, it's her. And then I got two bags of pretzels. This is like, it must be the old person in me or my grandmommy, because I love pretzels. Like, when I say I love pretzels, like I love pretzels with
I really love pretzels with peanut butter or like jam, just dipping them. That's a super weird snack, but I just love pretzels. So I got some pretzels as well. Now, people always be like, how you a vegetarian and you eat those? Because I can, and it's not real chicken in it, okay? It may be a broth or a bouillon cube. I've got some cup of noodles. Let me tell you, I don't care how old I get. I don't care how much money I make because I'm going to be making millions, right? I will forever eat a cup of noodles. Like, it's just something about grabbing a cup of noodles that just does it for me. Every time I need a snack. Also, I typically could take the noodles. Like, I'll probably end up making pho. So, that's what we'll do. We'll make pho one of these days. I can use these noodles for pho. Duh. But, yeah. I got three of these for real. So, that's everything I got from Aldi's to Trader Joe's. So, from Trader Joe's, I got this. I think I showed you guys this. But I got this grass-fed... I don't know why my camera is not focusing. Okay, I got this grass-fed Angus beef, ground beef. So, wait a minute. Is this vegan? I don't even think this freaking is vegan. It said it was meatless. Grass-fed Angus beef, ground beef. Oh, bitch. This shit got a, I think this shit is real meat. Oh, I need to take this back. Oh, no. I could have sworn it said meatless when I was in the store. I must have just been shopping. So it was in the meatless section. Like, when I said it was this one and, like, some more, like, it was in that section. But it says ground beef. Like, I think this is real meat, y'all. What's the ingredients? Oh, my God. I'm going to have to Google it. Where's my phone? I'm so serious because it was in the meatless section. I know it was in the meatless section. Grass fed. It would say meatless or something like that. Angus beef, Trader Joe's. Is this meatless? So tight. Okay, but I also did get a vegan. I didn't get it from Trader Joe's. I got this from Kroger. Yeah, I got this from Kroger. See, this says plant-based ground. And then that kind of shocked me. I don't even know where I put that joint at, but it kind of shocked me because it said, wow, I can't believe I got the wrong meat. But at least I have this one, so I got this too. And I got this from Kroger. So this is what I'm going to eat. I'm taking the other one back tomorrow. Moving along, I got this oat beverage. Now, I normally drink the Khalifa Farms oat milk, but I'm like, let me try this. I only got one, and I'm going to tell you why I only got one. Because it says non-dairy oat beverage, mildly sweet. And for some apparent reason, it says who knew oats and water could be mildly sweet. I'm scared it's going to taste a lot like water, so that's why I only got one instead of getting two just to be on the safe side. But I got this right here. We're going to see, though. But like I said, I got one. I got these chips right here. I was like, ooh, these look good. I love chips and sauces too, like as a snack. So they're carrot and tomato, spinach and garlic, red beet and onion chips. Omega-3 fatty acids per serving. 5,000. That's actually 500. Excuse me. That's actually really good. So veggie and flaxseed corn tortilla chips. So I got these. I was like, ooh, these sound real good. Ooh, they smell good. Wow, they're so soft. Like, I never heard of crunch, but they're very soft. That's good. I'm gonna see, don't play it up. Okay, also, I got some everything bagels. So we have an avocado toast this week. The gluten-free ones, because I want to start to, like, reduce gluten from my diet. I'm not sure if it has anything to do with skin or anything like that, but I'm trying to take every proper precaution. Okay, so I got two of these, two gluten-free, everything bagels. And then, I got tomatoes as well. So I got two tomatoes. I got two of everything. Like, I always do that. I just rather be prepared. I would hate to, like, I hate, like, not having something. So I always get, like,
two of them because I'm like, if I finish it, then I got a backup. Instead of like me finishing it, they're like, damn, I gotta go to the store. But like, that's so inconvenient. Like, I hate to be mildly inconvenienced. And then lastly, I think I showed you guys this too, was this matcha green tea latte mix that I picked up. It was like, I don't know how much it was, but it says 5 tablespoons of mix with 10 ounces of hot water, or you can have an ice. So I think it's really good. Cane sugar, coconut oil, matcha green tea, non-fat milk powder, malted milk powder. Damn, it's a lot of shit in here. So yeah, we're going to try it, but I thought it was really, really, you know, an instant latte made with sweetened Japanese matcha green tea. So that's pretty good. So I got this one here. And then I stopped at Sephora. Your girl definitely made it there. I almost forgot. Because my esthetician was like, you need a sunscreen. I'm hearing a lot about this Super Goop one. And then when I went to Sephora, she was like, yeah, that's a really good one. Everybody gets that. And they also said that it goes on, like, not white. Like, it doesn't give you, like, that white cast. So I'm going to try this tomorrow. And we're going to just see. We're going to see how it goes. But that is all that I got from the grocery store. I'm getting ready to take my baby outside because she done ate, and I know she's ready for a walk because we haven't spent any QT today. I will see you guys tomorrow. Yes, I wanted to bring God in, but sometimes I'll be like, I don't know about you, but yes, I believe in God. Yes, I know he's leading me. My mentor, well, that's one of my mentors. She just got added. And it's just like, you get added to my mentor list when everything like just hits. It's not long at all. It's a good list. Each mentor I had tailors a different part of me, and I just love that. And it was so, just helped me. I was writing stuff down like no other. She just helped me put my thoughts and my dreams and my desires into like this picture that I've been trying to do for so long, and it's been taking me a while to do it because I had this thing called fear, because that's what we were talking about. And she was just like, you know, find out whether or not you're doing is fear-based or not, right? Because a lot of things that we tend to deal with, there are fear-based. Oh, I can't do that because somebody's gonna say this. Oh, I can't do that because it's gonna look like this. Oh, I can't do that because I don't have money. Or I can't do that because whatever, yada yada yada, you know, da 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 da. And she was like, weigh out whether or not all these fear-based things are giving you a peace of mind. I'm like, like, you know, like, it was just one of those situations where it was like everything just came full circle. And she was like, you know, like, you got to be able to trust that whatever it is that you want to do, and I'm giving a little bit, she was like, you got to be able to trust that whatever it is that you want to do, God got you. And I was just like, I've been hearing that so much these past couple of days. Like, no matter what it is that I want to do, no matter how it is that I feel about certain situations, certain people, you know, dreams, aspirations, whatever it is, I may have that first thought of thinking about all of the negative things that happen, but it's like if I diminish those negative thoughts, feelings, emotions, or whatever the case is, and just always put the number one person first, which is God, there is no way, shape, or form that I'm not going to be able to achieve and attain everything that I want to achieve if I put him first. And I say this all the time, whenever you feel like something is not working out the way it is supposed to, like, just know that it is, because it could be the slightest thing. It could be a phone call, it could be an affirmation quote coming to your phone, it could be a video you see, it could be this video, it could be anything. Like, just know that everything is a sign. Everything is ordained. Everything happens for a reason. So just trust it. You gotta believe it. You gotta see it. You gotta feel it. You gotta dream it. You have to do all of these things. Whew. Because then that just shows God in the universe. Giving it to them. They ready for it because they showing me that they trust it. They showing me that they believe it. They showing me that they're able to see it. So soon, in a matter of time, they're going to be ready to receive the blessing. So, woo, child. That's all I got to say. I ain't cry. Because I don't cry. Well, I haven't cried. But I felt like this is a good way to start today. It takes us. My mentor held me accountable to a lot of things today, too. So I need to make sure that I check those off the list. So all the fun stuff might come after. But I had to do, like, all the administrative stuff. She, like, definitely held me accountable. Don't be for today, guys. I know I came on super duper hype. I went through, like, a bunch of emotions just now. But if I didn't, I wouldn't be sitting here being unapologetically myself. Get the day started. Church today, because gotta praise the Lord on a Sunday. But the last thing you guys saw was me trying to get my computer all set up and situated and do some administrative stuff, so that was a success, which is really, really good. I'm happy for that. Yesterday, which was Saturday, I got a chemical pill. I didn't record that because you guys have already seen me get a chemical pill, so I didn't see the need to do that again. That's just repetitive to me. But yeah, so I'm just like hanging around in the house for the next couple of days, just, you know, because that downtime is something serious. But in the meantime, I was like, Jasmine, you completely thrifted the last vlog and you didn't even show the gym fits. So I'm going to insert the clips of the gym fit try on haul. Make sure that you do subscribe. Also hit the like button. Let me know down in the comments some more videos you would like to see as well. I hope that you guys have a wonderful, beautiful, prosperous week, and I will see you guys in the next video.